Good start. Good start there. I do love when I start talking and then I forget that I have my microphone muted. That's lovely. Hello, everyone. As I was just saying, we're getting ready for...
David with the... Live. I barely know. Live.
Fair enough. Thanks, David, for the 13 months of Prime. I feel like I've not seen you in a while. You popped up in the Discord earlier and now here and I'm like, David remembers me? I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Hope you're doing well, lad. But yeah, we are watching Gamescom opening night live. This is a yearly gaming conference, one of Jeff Keighley's little trailer-thons. All I got for the intro was, for fuck's sake. Yeah, you see that, can't you? But yeah, so we're going to watch it all together. We're going to have a good time. We're hoping, as the stream title says, that we're going to see the Sonic Movie 3 trailer today. Because Jeff Keighley did say there'd be non-gaming things at the gaming conference, which suggests trailers for maybe films or adaptations of some kind. So it would make sense considering the Sonic Movie 3 is due out in 4 months exactly from today. And there hasn't been a single bit of marketing yet aside from Keanu Reeves being announced as Shadow and Eggman coming back, Jim Carrey, which they announced in like February this year, like 6 months ago, which is insane to think. Merch is appearing everywhere in like US toy stores and everything, like with Sonic Movie 3 branding on. So at some point the trailer's got to come out. So we're hoping it's going to be today. But apart from that, we're going to just watch the conference and see what there is, see what's going on. It's Keanu Reeves is playing Shadow the Hedgehog. That was confirmed. So we do know that. But yeah, so we're going to watch the conference and see what it's like. And that's why you won't see it on the VOD because I cut it off just after it. But the music we played today was Live and Learn because it's from Sonic Adventure 2, which Sonic Movie 3 is supposedly going to be heavily influenced by. So there you go. There you go. Then there's me who hasn't tuned in since like 2023. What, into one of my streams? You've been in my streams this year. What do you mean hasn't tuned in since 2023? Huh? What? What went wrong in casting for them to get Keanu Reeves to show that? What do you mean what went wrong? What do you mean what went wrong? That is peak casting. Oh, some people, chat, some people. No. So, we want this screen here. There we go. So, something is happening right now with the Game Awards for, like, I think it's like a pre-show thing, which is about to end. And then the main show will begin in about 3 minutes. And we will see what that's like. We'll see what it's like. And go. Is that Lashana Lynch? I swear I recognize her face. She's in Captain Marvel, James Bond, not Spectre, No Time to Die. She's been in a few other bits as well. Yeah, I know her face. That is her. Yeah. What the fuck is... What is this? Hang on a minute. I'm putting the sound on. What is this? The hell is this? Also, yeah, I have chocolate milk because I'm all relaxed tonight. Directive 8020. Dark Pictures. That's the...
believe, but we have just play, one tell people? Trailer left in this pre-show.
One trailer left.
Remember, back at Summer Game Fest, Capcom announced that Terry Bogard would be joining Season 2 of Street Fighter 6.
Okay, so I don't care. Good to know. Sorry if you care about Street Fighter, but I want to talk a bit before the show starts, and that is not relevant to me. The generation... Yeah, so there's been a new trailer that came out earlier for Sonic X Shadow Generations, and I haven't seen it. I didn't watch it anyway, because I was just like, I don't know if I need to see any more footage, because I'm waiting for the game to come out. But apparently, Ellian said there's a nice surprise in there. So we'll see if that shows during the show and figure out if there's anything cool in there. That could be nice. Can you join the Panic Room remake movement? What do you mean? What, for Payday 3? I'm going to be real with you. No, I'm sorry. I'm not going to do that. I'm watching it too and it syncs to yours. Really? Damn, that must mean my stream delay is good. So I'll fucking take it. I'll take it. But how are you all doing? Let's get the last minute, as we always like to do, folks. The last minute predictions. Anything you guys are hoping for or would like to see reveal today? Any games you're longing for or things that have been leaked that you're still waiting to hear back from? Let me know. Also, something else hadn't even realized yet when I said earlier that I didn't expect was show. Okay, intriguing. Life is Strange. I really hope we don't see any Life is Strange stuff. This is just me, but once I know about the game and I've seen the initial trailer, I just tune out. I don't need to know more about the game. I know I will play it and I don't need to be teased more. So I'm good. I'm good. I think we're going to get trailers for games. So true. In fact, you know what? For this, we can have the chat box on. Let's pop that on. Let's have the chat box on. Why not? Okay.
2024 is now officially just seconds away. Thank you for hanging out with me here and Mucho too.
There we go. Let me know if I need to turn the volume up or down, but I think that should be about right. We don't need Life is Strange stuff. We know enough, including the release date. So fucking hell, it's yellow. What is this, a cyberpunk apology PNG? Fuck off. Good grief. That was too bright. That was too bright!
Please. Sheesh! Welcome your host,
here he comes!
Creator of the Game Awards, Jeff
Cheers, Jeff. Here he comes. Also, there's going to be another announcement for a guest for Liverpool Comic Con like any moment now. So if my friend Heather pops up in chat and starts telling me who it is again, then no, ignore that. I won't ignore it, but she's thinking it's going to be more Baldur's Gate people since Neil Newbern got announced last night. But we'll see. Gamescom!
And hello to everyone watching around the world.
Game shows and chalky milk, nothing better than it, chat.
Cologne, Germany, and we have our biggest we got subtitles? Live audience of fans ever. Here at Kölnmesse, over 5,000 people together as a community to celebrate our love of games, and of course, millions of you watching online.
It's a little bit
world.
Chunky, so I'm going to leave
well,
that. If anyone really wants to, let me know.
For the grand kickoff to Gamescom, the world's biggest in-person video game event, and this is our sixth opening night live.
I do want to go to a Gamescom. It's going to happen
soon. We
have
a live sign language stream of ONL to make the show even more accessible. Thank you to Kaborski, who's shining the show right now. Thank you, Kaborski.
Yeah, it was an ASL version of the stream, which is really cool. I saw that mentioned
now,
earlier.
Now, while the game industry certainly has faced challenges this year, I know that ONL will get you excited about what's to come later this year and in 2025 and beyond. Now, over the next 2 hours, you're going to see world premieres from studios and small, including, yes, some new game announcements you're not expecting and some surprises, so get ready. From Monster Hunter to Indiana Jones, Dune to Civilization, Call of Duty to Marvel Rivals, the most anticipated games will be on stage tonight because they wanted to be here with you guys at Gamescom, and I am so honored and grateful to have the opportunity to present these games to you.
They're gonna make Jeff do this till he's 90? I think he's doing it of his own volition. What do you mean, Gluten?
So Gamescom, sensi bereit for the world premiere?
Was that German? I'm guessing that was German.
All right, here's our first world premiere, a brand new game announcement. This one hasn't leaked, and it's exclusive right here at ONL.
All right. Come on. You know what I say by now? As long as we get at least one great game that I'm interested in, that'll do. Ooh, Borderlands? I see 2K, I think Borderlands. Oh, shit, it actually might be. Oh, fuck, I might be onto something. Hang on. Is it Borderlands? I don't play Borderlands, I'm just aware of it. Why is it like Coruscant? It's not a Star Wars game, is it? No, it can't be. It wouldn't be. It's got to be Borderlands. Don't do that. Don't do that to me. Yeah, this looks like Borderlands. Why the fuck is Coruscant in Borderlands, though? What's happening there? The only thing that makes me think it's not is there's a distinct lack of cell shading at the minute. Is that a Borderlands thing? Hey? Oh, yeah, there you go. Bingo. I fucking guessed it from 2K Games. What the fuck? Oh, yep, yeah, you can't see it on my camera. Hang on. There, Borderlands 4. There you go. It's been confirmed. 2025. Cool. I mean, that had to happen at some point, right? That's a good way to distract people from the fucking film bombing.
2025. Next up, October 25th marks the release of Call of Duty Black Ops 6.
Can't fucking wait.
Extended look at the campaign gameplay. Please welcome John Zuck
Alrighty?
And Catherine Anderson.
That felt like something you could have left to later in the show, but alright. I'm not sure how much I care about the campaign, but I did really like Cold Wars, so I can't remember if it takes place right after, doesn't it? So I probably will enjoy it.
Black Ops Returns, with an epic story and signature blockbuster action.
Black Ops Returns, at this point, we're 6 games in. Has it ever fucking left?
It features an all-new campaign with 16 new multiplayer maps.
Okay.
With a return of classic prestige and theater mode. And 2
theater mode.
New zombies experiences on day one.
Whoa, shit!
You'll see live MP, zombies, and Warzone gameplay at the Call of Duty Next event on August 28th.
I don't care, I'm just there for the zombies. The zombies look fucking nuts.
You'll be able to join the MP open beta to try out the brand new Omni movement system for yourself.
I will be streaming that August 30th.
We're here representing the Raven team, who's leading the campaign in partnership with Treyarch.
Okay. Well, Raven always tends to cook.
The Black Ops 6 campaign is set in the early 90s. a time of global turmoil and uncertainty as the Cold War comes to an end.
Okay.
You're joined by legendary characters Frank Woods, the grizzled vet, and Russell Adler, the ultimate wild card. Together with new allies Troy Marshall and Jane Harrow, and unbound by normal rules of engagement, you'll unravel a mind-bending conspiracy. In the mission we're about to show you, our rogue team has targeted a senator attending a political fundraiser in order to gain access to a top secret black site underneath Washington, D.C.
This is Most Wanted.
So, Black Ops 2 spoilers if anyone hasn't played the campaign yet.
Show up to this
like
fundraiser.
Is this after Mason dies? Because they didn't say Mason. And I only just had that spoiled for me recently. I didn't know until like a couple weeks ago that Mason fucking dies in Black Ops 2's campaign. I actually didn't fucking know that. And I was watching, I think it was Jolems, who does like those platinum videos, and he was like, oh, you find out you've killed Mason. And I went, huh? I didn't know that!
Use your camera to get a better look. The senator isn't giving interviews tonight.
Is that fucking Bill Clinton? What the fuck? Is that? What did that lad call him on the stream? What was it? Orthodox Rabbi Bill Clinton? Holy shit.
The senator stole some sensitive information from the people I work for.
Who the hell are you?
Blackmailing the senator with sex tapes. Can't beat the classics.
I've cleaned up another of your messes.
Lee Grisham, head of security for All Drain Energy.
Grisham might be our way to McKenna.
Oh, QCE. Oh, fuck me. Oh ho. I did really like Cold War's campaigns. If it's like that, I'm good. Did I miss anything? Borderlands 4 got announced. Ooh. Yeah, I really liked Cold War's campaign. So if this is anything like that, I'll be quite happy. But for me, first off, I don't have to pay anything to play the game because it's on Game Pass, but the zombies looks fucking phenomenal, and that's enough for me. Anything else that's good is a bonus.
It must be Pantheon.
Pantheon, why is that the Perseus of this game?
We can do this loud or quiet.
Go. There's different ways to engage. Cool. Black Ops 6 is one of the first COD games looking forward to, mainly because it's on Game Pass. Valid, David, valid.
We're here to help.
But it's also just because I have such a pers- Whoa! Oh, it's Adler.
My message. The old man says you're worth it. Better be right. Sev, we got the prize.
Good. Now get out.
Did his hair just flop? Has Adler's hair got physics?
You good to go?
I am now.
Oh, you should have said we got a job to do. What the hell, man? Oh, hello. I eat Molotovs for breakfast at enemy. Yeah, real. Juggernaut dude from Black Bank Ice 101. No, that was just Juggernaut. It was Stun Gun Dude and Juggernaut. What the fuck? You got a fucking weapon wheel? Or is that just like power-ups wheel or something? What is that? Ain't no way he couldn't blow that shit up before I got to him. Although I do buy the RCXD being that lethal. It's always been a pain in the ass.
Like progress.
Up through the service hatch. You two first. I'll give you a boost. You first, Adler.
Come on. We got a job to do, Bell.
Come on, Case.
Never mind. Bell's already dead. Because he killed Bell. You kill the fucking person this campaign again, Adler, and I swear I'm going to put a fucking warrant out for your arrest,
easy
even though you're in the 90s.
Down. Here.
I mean, realistically, just on a real level, this looks fucking amazing visually. If all of this is in engine, which it looks like it is, then this really is phenomenal. Whoa! Whoa! Where's Adler?
Adler!
There he is.
I got you.
That was pretty cool.
Man, you're heavier than you look.
Thanks. Hope you have a plan B.
Same as plan A. Go up. We'll just take the scenic route. Let's get moving.
Meeting the future, Bill Clinton! Was that an actual campaign poster of his? I actually want to know now. Is there anyone in the chat old enough to know if that was a Bill Clinton campaign poster? It looks like it is, because that looks like his actual face on there. It looks like an actual picture of him, like not an in-game one. That's wild. This shit gonna be over 200 gigs because of Warzone? Well, don't install Warzone then. You don't have to install it with the rest of this game, surely. Everything's always segmented, which I really like. What the fuck?!
If we can't outgun them, we outrun them.
Just like that, huh?
Just like that.
His hair has got physics! That... I love that shit, man.
Ever do anything like this before?
No. But I don't see any better options, and I'm running out of bullets.
What the fuck? Look, you're never gonna get me be cynical anyway about shit like this, but man, this looks fucking cool. I'm in. This looks so good. These fellows seem a tad not legal. Well, I mean, this is Black Ops. These are off the grid. Just saying. Alright, there's a more general little sizzle reel for it. I'm in. Again, I don't need to say I'm in because, again, Game Pass, but still. Yep, so August 30th, as soon as the beta starts, I will be doing a stream. So make sure you follow the Twitch for that. If you're not already following, then press the button.
There you go, Black Ops 6, more coming at Call of Duty next. And now I'm honored to introduce my co-host for Opening Night Live. You know her from her years of hosting League of Legends esports around the world. Did you know that she got her start as a competitive Unreal Tournament player? That's right. Please join me in welcoming to ONL, Shox.
Who? I don't know who that is. Has she done any co-hosting things before? I know he's had co-hosts before.
Tom, thank you for the warm welcome. Unreal Tournament, that is quite... the throwback, but I am so excited to be here tonight revealing many of the games on Opening Night Live and highlighting events happening during this Gamescom week in Cologne. Gamescom really is the best week for games worldwide every year, and I am so stoked to be back here with you all celebrating it. Now, it is my pleasure to share a message from Gamescom to you, our gaming community.
Payday was there last year, Crime Boss is there this year. Dear future, I'm fucking missing out, man. How expensive are flights to Germany? I should go next year.
I hope you visit wonderful places. That you have friends from places far away. And that you always have the best adventures.
Man, this looks right up my fucking street. I need to go.
And that you love the things you do. Dear future me, my favorite thing in the world is to play. Do you like to play too?
Okay.
Yes, the future is here and we are ready to play. Let's take a look at this fun trailer.
CGP. What, the old high school textbooks? Oh, no, what is this? Eh? The hell is this? What the fuck? Re-release Ward. Okay. What's happening here? Some games being re-released? There's something to do with the combination of eras here, like console generations. I just heard you're finally awake, and that looked like Joel and Ellie on that cart. Jesus and Andreas! What the fuck is this? What the hell is this? What the hell is being cooked here? Is that a goat? No, it's not a goat simulator DLC, is it? Oh no. Oh, for fuck's sake it is, isn't it? Oh, for fuck's sake. Goat Sim 4, could it be? I thought Goat Sim 3 was still getting support, I imagined it was. This does seem very coffee stained to do. Oh no, he's broken out! What the fuck? Wait, what?
Yeah. In my opinion, that looks
really?
Like the goat of all remasters.
Okay, this is not that guy. I'm genuinely asking because I barely play the original. Does that game need a remaster?
Of thousands of fans at Gamescom.
It's not even that old, is it?
Person. But if you cannot be here with us, don't worry. You can join us virtually.
I know I can't talk because I got excited about games that really didn't need remasters, but that feels like a waste of a fantastic trailer for something I'm not bothered by.
Studio is here with all day coverage.
Fucking cool trailer.
So tune in to Gamescom Studios broadcast by IGN on Twitch or on
YouTube. All right, chat, I'm out of chalky milk. That means I'm now going to be extremely cynical for the rest of the stream. I hate video games. I hope every video game doesn't... No, I'm just going to say doesn't release, but it's too far. You did The Last of Us Part 2, and here we are. Yeah, that's true. That's very true.
It's time to reveal a surprising boss fight coming to the game.
Tomorrow and all the days after it will be March 31st.
Persona?
Tartarus all over again.
Looks like an Atlas thing.
There's a connection between all of you and what's happening. Let's just open it, then we'll know. Something's wrong.
Careful what you say about Persona in the chat, folks. Elian will have you. And he's got mod powers, so don't fight Elian. Oh, for Christ's sake.
Joker fun there. Alright. Next up, we have another new game.
I don't know why Heather didn't spam me in the Twitch chat, but it has been confirmed that Jennifer English is going to Liverpool Comic Con. Fuck's sake! Why are all the good ones going? I haven't got the money for this! Fucking Shadowheart going to Liverpool. Fuck! Fuck! Oh, she did spam the chat? And what, I didn't see it? When? When did she say it? I've been looking at the chat all time.
He's close.
Oh, she said Jen earlier as one highlighted message.
Thank God.
I'm gonna surprise. I did say tell her to spam me. I told her to spam me. But anyway, whatever.
On me.
What is this? Dying Light? Okay.
Contact.
Swear I just saw Deadpool and Wolverine for a second. Did you? Oh, was it? Did I like? Did I very briefly do that on my screen? It's my wallpaper. Whenever I switch to the upper window, it does that. Sorry.
You might unleash the beast.
Thank you.
There you go. Kyle Crane is back in a new zombie adventure set in the Dying Light world with 20 hours of gameplay, a new open world region, and more in Dying Light, The Beast. Next, today marks the launch for the most wishlisted game right now on Steam, and also, last I checked, the biggest single-player game ever on Steam with over 2 million concurrent
Yeah, how did this happen?
Black Myth Wukong from Game Science in China, which is also out on the PlayStation 5. And right now, we've got the reveal of the launch trailer for you.
Yeah, I've seen trailers for this for the last couple of years, this Black Myth Wukong, and apparently, yeah, it's become the biggest, like, the most concurrent players for a single-player game on Steam ever. And, like, I swear, outside of trailers, I've heard no hype for this, so I'm just surprised. It's not like Baldur's Gate 3, where everyone was talking about it when it came out. I didn't even know this had come out. I mean, I've seen trailers for this before, so I'm not particularly bothered by it. I know that much, but it's interesting. Oh, I like how everybody is saying China. Is that what it is? Okay. To be fair, like, what was it? 2 million people playing in on Steam, and how many people live in China? So if it's really big in China, I'm not really surprised that it's blown up. Because China's like, what, 1 point something billion? Wake up, honey, another soul's like just dropped to the millionth one. I don't know if it's just a soul's like. I'm personally just not interested looking at this. If someone says to me, do you want to play a Dark Souls style game where you play as a monkey, I'd go, no, I'm good. It's fair, I don't really mind. Roger Craig Smith is voicing that guy from Dying Light. That's cool. I do like Roger Craig Smith, but I've only ever played a tiny bit of the first Dying Light. It's never been a franchise I've been that interested in. I think I got a review code for Dying Light 2 a while ago, and then something happened and I couldn't play it, so I'd still have got the game, but eventually I might play it. Dragon Ball, okay. My eyes!
Unleash the power.
Follow from Abdel Kader, thank you very much. Pacing of the Souls like release every day. It's not every day. People moan about certain genres, but it's like. My eyes, anyways. I mean, yeah, it basically is. I don't care for Dragon Ball, so. My friend Heather was just saying about how she did spam me in chat and I just completely missed it because she said you were too busy worrying about fucking Black Ops. I was like, she just spammed me more. She should just spam me more, man. That would have been exciting to see. But either way, I've seen it myself, so. Why have we got animated Jeff Keighley?
From the Construct Coliseum, it's time for everyone's favorite game, King of
We joined recently kidnapped celebrity guest contender Jeff Keighley at the starting line.
Wait, starting line?
And that battle cry King of Meat. Jeff is to any project. Let's check the so what the fuck is he wearing on his feet, bro? What are those shoes?
He's throwing everything at these contenders, but the JK machine is leading the way to the finish line and the chat is blowing.
What is all this? Death traps, unapproved nicknames, and a giant horse trying to hoof me?
An eloquent and marketing-friendly description of the game, not to mention a perfectly timed transition to the world premiere trailer for King of Meat!
Ready for action? Ready for mayhem? Ready for gold and fame pouring from the sky? Challenges from the most twisted minds of the most ghoulish dungeon creators.
Yeah, Pitbull, that's kind of where I'm at as well. Like, I'm more thrown off that they thought the best way to advertise this was to start by putting Jeff Keighley in it. Like, I'm really confused what is happening. Also, I can't wait to get copyright claim for this song.
Insane in the brain!
Yeah,
Still got it, Keely. Still got it.
I'm good. I'm good, thanks. I'm all right.
Welcome back to Opening Night Live for real this time, and that was the announcement of King of Meat, an online co-op spectacle for 1 to 4 players from Glowmade in Guildford, England, and Amazon Games.
More like King of Meat Rising!
Now, one of the things I absolutely love about making these shows is that we get to introduce you to brand new games and teams like this one. To reveal their first game from their new studio, Fuzzybot, please welcome Tatiana Dishlova and Max Spielberg.
Max Spielberg?
Hello?
I swear I know that name. Is it for the obvious reason?
Guys, welcome to ONL. I'm very excited to share this game with the world. Can you tell us a little bit about your studio, first of all?
Yeah, well, first off, it's totally surreal to be here right now. We started the studio back in 2020, and the majority of us had come from the AAA side of the industry. And at the time, we were just thrilled to have our own game, our own IP, and we could never expect being on the stage tonight at the end of that run.
The vision for our studio started with the idea of dreaming big and building smart. The concept for our first game, even early on, felt
very Why is the guy on the front just
heart,
ninja?
This helped us bring together a very passionate team of talented developers. It's through their skill, dedication, and true love for the game that we're able to be here tonight, going way beyond where we thought we'd be.
Well, I got to play this a few months ago with you guys. I had a
Tell us a bit about your We're going to play the Jeff Keighley drinking game.
Yeah. So our debut game.
Every time he says, I got to play this, or you showed me this earlier, you have to do a drink.
Slash with a bit of roguelike
so do a shot.
Elements. And so we blended these ideas together to create this cozy yet highly kinetic action game for players to brawl, build, and befriend a crew of adorable robots. In it, it's the year 3000, and you're going to take on the role as one of the last remaining humans on
Has much changed? Do they live underwater?
Along with a friendly bot faction, you're going to aim to take down the Combot Army, hell-bent on organic destruction. Players can play alone or with friends in this vibrant world of robots.
Or, a simpler way that I like to describe it sometimes is, you go out and fight the evil robots, and then collect their body parts to build a sustainable town of your dreams while saving the cute ones. We are incredibly proud to finally reveal the delightful world of Linked Banner of the Spark, and we hope the players get as much joy out of playing it as we have building it.
Well, we're very excited to show it to the world for the first time. Let's take a look at the world premiere reveal trailer. Thanks, guys.
Okay. I swear I know the name Max Spielberg. I swear I've heard that somewhere. Has he done something else that I don't know about? I don't remember. Doesn't look like my kind of game. The coolest thing in the drop of the trailer for me is the music right now. No, I'm not thinking of Steven Spielberg. I did think that for a second, but I think I actually have heard the name Max Spielberg somewhere else. I'm gonna look it up real quick. Oh! Without fucking dropping my phone on the keyboard, ideally. Sheesh. Let's see. Max Spielberg. Oh, am I thinking of the fucking photo store, Max Spielman? Is that what I'm thinking of? No, hang on. Steven Spielberg does have a son called Max Spielberg. Is it him? Is that the guy? Might be him. No, it's not the same. Yeah, no. I was going to say. So maybe I am just overthinking it. Possible. It's entirely possible.
Well, I think we can all agree on this fact. Fishing makes every video game better. Now, one of the things that I love about Gamescom is that it is a safe place for our diverse gaming family. And there is an amazing platform called Gamescom Cares that shares social and environmental responsibility projects that we care deeply about. Thanks to all of our partners who helped to make this happen. You can learn more by scanning the QR code below.
That's nice, but I'm not going to do that.
And now, the first look at the gameplay of Lost Records, Bloom and Rage.
Ooh.
A narrative adventure from the creative minds behind Life is Strange.
I'm intrigued by this. Although the last Dontnod game I played was Life is Strange 2, and I have very middling thoughts about that. This does look good. So let's see. Let's have a little look.
Honestly, Swan, I'm glad, but slightly surprised that you showed up tonight.
When I saw your text, all these memories came flooding back.
Hey, she actually showed.
Welcome!
I remembered Nora, her energy.
Shit! Where's my fucking pick?
The Tharp one's her favorite. I remembered you.
Nice one, Autumn.
You were the coolest.
Skateboarder's wisdom. Never land on your wrist.
I want to see you skateboard, Autumn. I remembered Kat.
Whoa, watch out!
She was like a firecracker.
Fuck!
This is serious. We're gonna need a real band name.
How about Bloom and Rage?
How could I forget?
Wasn't Vortex Club the name of the club in Life is Strange? It was indeed. I didn't even pick that up myself.
Last week, my mom found a package on her doorstep. Wait. Are Bloom and Rage?
Oh. Okay.
Are we in trouble?
It comes out in two parts, yeah. Don't love that. Might wait till the second part comes out and then try it. We'll see.
You'll excuse me.
That was a very abrupt ending. I was enjoying seeing a bit of that. Oh well. Plot twist, Chloe shows up in this game and not Double Exposure. Let's not say that. Let's not tempt fate.
I wanted to tell you all, we failed in our duty to God.
The fuck?
We were told about all of this. And these here are the last days of this earth.
No More Room in Hell 2. Yeah, haven't we seen a trailer for that already? I think we might have done, and I thought it looked pretty cool. I seem to remember.
That game looks great. It's a new look at the 8-player co-op of No More
Room in Hell 2
from Torn Banner up in Canada, where there are deadly consequences of not sticking close to your teammates, and I cannot wait to check that one out. All right, our next game, it's been a long time coming for this next one. At the Game Awards in 2021, Embark Studios revealed Arc Raiders, a game that immediately struck a chord with players around the globe. A stunning future Earth where menacing Arc machines threaten humanity's attempts to rebuild. Well, Arc Raiders has evolved a lot since then, and now it's finally time for some news on what's next for this exciting action survival shooter.
Okay.
Where do we go from here?
And the person who likes this game? What, the one person? There's got to be more, right?
You've told us nothing of this place. Look at us now.
Quarter of the way through. I was just thinking that myself, and I was like, how far into the show are we? I was just trying to work it out, and then I realized, oh yeah, it started at 7. It's 7:34. So that covers the Levine's.
But even more to gain.
Probably isn't, but it fucking looked like her. Arc Raiders. Okay. Playtesting starts this fall. What kind of game is it, though? What kind of game is it? Okay, never mind then. Infold. That's a fucking tonal shift if I've ever seen one. Same game, imagine. Here's what the playtest for Arc Raiders looks like now. Infinity Nikki. Oh, didn't Jeff Keighley tweet about this like yesterday or something? Saying he played like a couple hours of it. Suddenly it's Dark Souls. What the hell was that? White woman no longer interested. Jeez, Noelle, alright. Is this like anime character does Pokemon? The coziest open world game. Okay. What's this then? Oh, Warhammer. Okay. Skill up! That's fucking weird seeing a YouTuber you watch pop up in the fucking reviews for a trailer. What the hell? The influence of YouTubers, man. The first person to be quoted in the game trailer was a YouTuber. Mad. I've been blown away. Did Noli write this? What happened? Oh, is that it? Oh, okay. PC gamer was blown. Yeah, exactly. Feels like another case of the music is the best part of this trailer. Concord? No, it's not Concord. I feel like that game is just dead on arrival at this point. I don't know if Sony are going to put any more money behind marketing it with how badly it's doing. 2 million players? Oh, so it's a game that's out? What is it? It's definitely not Concord. It's definitely not Concord if it's got 2 million players. Sorry, I sound like I'm being really mean to them, but all I've seen is just how it's not doing well. I wasn't particularly jazzed about it when I saw the trailer, but I didn't think it looked bad. It just looked very... Yeah. It is funny seeing the way people have shifted against hero shooters in the last few years. I'm not saying I disagree, but like, especially in the last year or so, the amount of, oh God, stop with the hero shooters I've seen has risen exponentially. I've never been the biggest hero shooter guy anyway, to be fair, but still, it's interesting to see the narrative change towards that.
Built by an indie team from the ashes of Epic Games is Paragon, if you remember that one. It enters 1.0 free-to-play release tonight. Next up, Path of Exile 2 from Grinding Gear Games. It is nearing release, and tonight, yes, we do have news on the early access date. Check this out.
The date will be revealed in 3 months now.
My son... Are you clear
of
mind and stout of heart?
Ellie, you know Kingdom Come Deliverance is coming. You don't have to keep... it's coming, all right? Just relax. It's coming. It's coming. All right, it's coming. We know.
Are you ready to sacrifice?
You can I can't wait for you to blow up the live chat when it shows up.
The savior.
I will.
Oh, now my Twitter gets me a notification of Jennifer English going to Liverpool Comic Con.
This world,
fuck's sake.
And build it anew.
I must.
Baldur's Gate type of voices. Is that meant to be an insult? How dare you? Hope we get GTA 6 gameplay. That's not happening. Let's be real here. That is not happening. GTA 6 is now states to release fall 2025. So we've got probably still at least a year to go. Baldur's Gate 4. Stop. Stop it. That's what Star Wars are making, isn't it? That's Project Baxter. Baldur's Gate 4.
Your destiny.
What the hell is this? Ugh, that's creepy. Oh yeah, we know. Path of Exile. Why am I pretending like I didn't know that? Okay. Project Backshots. Fuck off. Why is that what we're calling it now? Fucking hell.
Well, that looks absolutely great. Can't wait for that one.
Is this even the place GT6 to be shown off? I doubt it.
Gamescom is known for the cosplay. The vision and dedication cosplayers put into their craft is an inspiration to us all. And to see these amazing cosplayers, you can tune in to the Gamescom Cosplay Awards on Saturday, August 24th at 5 p.m.
That sounds cool.
And if you're into indie games, who isn't, you can watch the best indies of Gamescom in our Gamescom Awesome Indie Show tomorrow at 8 p.m. on Twitch and YouTube. Enjoy exclusive announcements and interviews all packed into an exciting one-hour show hosted by Shay Thompson. Plus, the Gamescom Event Arena, that is where I am standing right now and all of you are. It is the biggest and most elaborate stage at Gamescom, featuring not only Opening Night Live, but additional live shows featuring creators, gaming events, and esports competitions.
Is it too late to sign up? Can I be involved?
Or by tuning in online. Now, up next is a first look at the gameplay of June Awakening, the open-world survival MMO.
Finally,
and
gameplay for
news
it?
News on when it's going to be released.
Okay. Isn't this only on PC, though? Because I would actually be intrigued by this. Oh, what the fuck? Stop that.
Awaken.
You begin as a nameless prisoner. Sculpt your appearance, choose your background, and then crash into the planet. You are abandoned and alone.
On Arrakis, right? Must be. Oh yeah, it's Arrakis, cool.
Hunted by sandworms. Scorched by the unforgiving sun, ravaged by sunstroke. Stick to the shade, chase the moving shadows, survive. Welcome to Arrakis, the most dangerous planet in the universe. Meet hundreds of other players in the vast online world. Befriend or betray those you meet. Form a wary alliance, in this case, a spit dart rifle and a stillsuit for your help taking down territorial deserters. Working with others will always increase your chance of staying alive. The deserter base.
I'll be honest, it might be the stream quality, but this looks like a 2016
violence.
Game.
Your
it
choice
look
of
as
weapons
fresh
and
as
abilities
it would.
Determines your strategy. Swordmasters lead the charge into battle, literally. Repel ranged attacks with a shield, and then take them out, one by one.
Yeah, yes, moment, that might also not be helping, yeah.
From the shadows. Take what you can from the fallen. On Arrakis, nothing of value is wasted.
The moisture, definitely the moisture.
Mine, harvest, and gather with your group to build bases and unlock more.
Yeah, it might be the stream quality. It does look like it's probably purifier. Pretty good behind the fucking
refine
weird,
the blood
blurry
you
nature of the stream.
Enemies to extract drinkable water.
Yeah, say
craft
moisture.
Improved equipment using fabricators. Replicate your bases in new locations with the blueprint system.
Why did you say three,
Vita? Blueprints of your architectural wonders to other players. Lead your group.
I'm blurry. Looks it on
hero.
My screen, Ellie.
On Arrakis,
stream's lower quality than my monitor is.
Can rise.
Then again, what is the stream resolution? Is it 1080p?
And take to the air.
Oh, that explains why it looks blurry then. Yeah, so it is the stream quality. 1080p on a 4040p monitor is going to look blurry. Went through a door and it said 3. Oh, yeah, it did, yeah.
The in-game radio provides insight into key events happening across Arrakis.
Am I playing on 1080p? I'm not complaining, I'm just saying that's why it looks blurry on my screen, not on yours. My screen is 1440p. If a video is lower resolution, that it will look blurry on my screen. I'm just saying a fact, I'm not complaining.
Arrakis is a vast planet. You can explore unique locations, uncover valuable resources, and search for secrets amongst the shifting dunes.
I don't love the look of this, I'll be honest.
And then return to civilization triumphant with what you found. Harko Village throngs with people. Spice traders, guild bankers, smugglers, house envoys, and of course, other players. Here, you will pledge allegiance to one of the great houses of Dune, the Harkonnen.
You have to pledge to the Harkonnen?
To play politics, you need power. And on Arrakis, spice is power. In the deep desert, beyond the shield wall, hundreds of players scour the landscape, hunting for spice. Every spice blow has the potential to become a heated battle, with multiple guilds vying for the precious melange. Even when it looks like defeat is inevitable, those who understand desert power.
Ooh, can you summon sandworms?
Arrakis itself.
Okay, that's cool. If a sandworm's gonna suddenly fucking show up, go on. Right, my only issue is how much of this is gameplay and how much this is for the sake of the trailer. Will that happen in game? Oh, it is coming to Xbox. Okay. All right. I'll certainly give it a shot when it comes out. I'm not blown away by it, I will say that,
well,
but I'll certainly give it a shot.
You can't have a Dune game without the sandworms, and the sandworm summoning begins when Dune Awakening drops on PC early 2025. So the wait is not that long. And now, here is a reveal of a new game from Tarsier Studios, the creators of Little Nightmares 1 and 2.
Nothing lasts forever.
That's a cool shot. Is this Little Nightmares 3 or? Gotta still look at my fucking phone, man. I swear I'm missing key information. Whoosh, there you go. Phone's gone. Nice. I've never played a Little Nightmares game, but I have heard good things about them. It's one of those genres that isn't like something that's completely in my circle.
I thought you were dead.
Also, there's like 50 people watching them, which is kind of nuts. So thank you all for doing that. I really appreciate you all hanging out. Reanimal. So it's not Little Nightmares 3. Okay.
That was Reanimal, the next big entry in the cozy game genre. Now, would you like to discover the secret contents of Gamescom and receive cool rewards? Well, meet Epi, the robot on our website RPG Gamescom Epics. Prove your nerd know-how, solve tricky puzzles, win prizes, gather trading cards, digital trading cards, and jump from level to level until the final boss spawns. Scan the QR code below and the adventure can begin. Now in its fourth year as an evolving open world
He's wrapping
today,
up.
Genshin Impact is unveiling Nation of Nutland, which will be released on August 28th. And we also have some news about when the game will be coming to Xbox.
Fucking Genshin. Wait, Genshin Impact's coming to Xbox? It would be one hell of a fucking turnaround if I tried the game and suddenly fucking liked it. Because, as you all know, I'm still bitter about it beating the Player's Choice Award against Sonic Frontiers. Genshin stream when? Imagine if I fucking streamed it! Do not play Genshin. What actually is the problem with Genshin? I think we've had this conversation before, but I always forget the answer. All I know is it's a very popular game. Like, is there an actual reason as to why y'all don't like it? It's a gacha game. It's like you're talking to me in fucking German. I don't know what you're saying. I don't know what you're saying, Callista. What do you mean, gacha game? What does that actually mean? Full of mini lads? Oh, what the fuck? Gambling. Yo, what do you mean? That's not my kind of game, man. Gambling? What the fuck? The true final boss of life, gambling. Advanced warfare supply drops on crack. Now you speak in my language.
Hmm.
99% of Genshin players quit before they pull a 5-star character. Oh.
There you go, Genshin Impact, and also coming to Xbox later this year, as we saw. All right, now it's time to head into the wilds of Monster Hunter, which is playable for fans for the first time here at Gamescom. Capcom has an incredible booth. But now, to tell us more and show us more, please welcome to the Gamescom ONL stage, Ryozo Tsujimoto from Capcom. Ryozo-san.
Brandon with the flow, thank you very much. Ellie, lay off a little bit, come on. Even if you're joking or not, that comes across for you in the chat. Anyone in the chat a Monster Hunter fan?
Hello to all of my friends in Germany and to the millions watching around the globe. I'm really thankful that Jeff has invited me to the opening night live stage so I can share a new Monster Hunter Wilds trailer with everyone.
Before we debut the trailer, I just want to express how excited I am to kick off our season of Monster Hunter Wild's hands-on demos starting at Gamescom. Now, let's take a look at the latest trailer.
Okay. Not particularly fussed by Monster Hunter, but let's see.
My word, is this a Lala Barina floor?
Maybe Ice-T will show up to reveal the next payday. Oh my days, that was a year ago. The Ice-T thing was a year ago. Oh, I just aged in a second. Oh my days. That was Gamescom last year. How have I forgotten that? Fucking hell. Around this time, 12 months ago, Ice-T fucking showed up in black and white and went, "What's up, Gamescom? I'm here because I'm in my favorite game, Payday." And I just was like, "What the fuck?" Oh, we need a 1,000-yard stare. I mean, it's insane, yeah, to think that Payday 3 is nearly a year old. Especially with how little content it's had. And before anyone Starbreeze watches and thinks I'm being negative, yes, Operation Medic Bag, I know. But content-wise,
once your business here is concluded,
you wouldn't think it'd been a year.
Find shelter.
It's crazy.
The sands come alive this time of year.
In before Mac never returns to Payday 3. Well, Ice-T said on his interview with Almir, like when the game came out, he just randomly went, "And that extra thing you got me to do, that extra Mac DLC or whatever he said." So, my bet's the next DLC. What if the next DLC is a Mac one? I highly doubt they prepared content after the end of year one. So if he's recorded something back then, it must have been for a year one. Oh, so actually, there's my crackpot theory. The next heist is a Mac heist. No evidence, that's just my guess. I apologize for anyone who likes Monster Hunter, I just don't personally give a shit, so let the trailer run and talk to you guys. The gameplay looks good. Yeah, sorry if I'm ruining this for you if you like Monster Hunter, I apologize. Yeah, we know there's only going to be one more heist in year one of Payday 3, and that's Fear and Greed. So. Okay, cool. Lost Hunter Wilds. In before DLC 4 gets renamed to Max Revenge. Imagine. And there's more.
So tasty.
Does Fear and Greed come out next month? Yeah, it's next month's update.
Danger lies at every turn.
Tomb Raider? Hello? What's that? Oh.
Treasure.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Secrets. Destiny.
I feel like I was just the visual representation of that fucking KSI meme. Where he's like, yes! 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 Shit! No! 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 Because I was like, Tomb Raider? Oh, hello, what? And then a Sunder Rocker Blade Point went up. Oh, okay. Sonic 3 trailer in the next hour, it's coming. I hope it is, Alien. I really hope it is.
Want a little taste of
I'll be honest, so far this show has been extraordinarily mid. It's all perspective, and it's all down to what you're into, but in terms of my personal tastes, I'm not seeing anything that's really interesting me. Borderlands 4 is a big announcement, but I don't play Borderlands, so it's like... quite a lot of zoom on their boobs. Welcome to the video game industry now. Ugh. Although, unfortunately, that joke might be at least slightly realistic, depending on the studio. Sub. What is this, by the way? City of Wolves. Fabricage just said Den of Wolves when, and they just said City of the Wolves. Fabricage, you want to manifest the Sonic trailer for us? Clearly you have influence here. Escort reactor core and upgrade Bunker City's power. Yeah, exactly. I say no after that joke, but it's not like it's not inaccurate to the video game industry. It is, yeah. Depends on who you talk to. Some studios know. Some, maybe. Especially certain genres. Features a shooter. I was guessing it was what's it called? Armor Core. Armor Core 6. Is that not what this is? Which I've heard again, good things about. Not something I care about personally. Honestly, when I fill things out, like when I apply to be like partners or like work with like studios, get review copies, things like that. Whenever I get a survey that's like, you know, what games are you into? I tend to tick so many options in the list because I could think of games that fit in every single genre I tick that I've liked. And then I watch a gaming show like this, and I go, is my taste just really niche? Is mine, like, really simple? I don't know. Or is it just the games that are being shown at some of these that just aren't for me? I do wonder sometimes.
That was a new look at
are you all feeling break, similar to me? Are there a lot of games you've seen that you like? Are you feeling like I am?
We have something exciting for fans of Monument Valley, the beautiful twisted puzzle game that we all played about a decade ago when it was first released in 2014.
Did
well,
we?
Tonight, we are revealing Monument Valley 3 coming later this year from Us 2 in London and Netflix Games. I played this. It is an absolutely beautiful, stunning game.
Take a drink.
We got your first
shot.
Look
shot.
Right now.
Ooh. Yeah, if you haven't gone to the stream yet, I have an ongoing game. I don't have anything against Jeff Keighley. I need to keep saying this because I feel like sometimes I take the piss out of him and it sounds like I have a thing against him. I don't. I think the Game Awards was not handled well last year, but that's not really necessarily all down to him, in my opinion, as a person. But one thing I've noticed that he does a lot in these shows is he goes, I played this early. Or like, especially he brings someone on stage and goes, you know, you talked about this to me a while ago, or you let me play this a while ago. And it just feels like a trademark of something he says whenever someone comes out on stage, or just generally. So we have a drinking game. And what, do you know, one day, maybe what we'll do when the Game Awards happens later this year, we'll do a drinking game if I stream it. I might not because I think it's going to be dead late, but it could be a very fun thing to do. You know? It's Jeff's, it's on the table. Basically, yeah. Basically. Anyway, cool. All right. Oh, Monument Valley Games coming to Netflix. I mean, that looks like a fun little puzzle game, so nothing against that.
Monument Valley 3 drops exclusively.
I'm surprised
on Netflix
how much of
December
what's
10,
her name, Shocks, there is in this, because his co-host
now,
often says a bit, but it feels like they
in
keep alternating.
1991. Civilization is one of
okay,
the gaming industry's biggest franchises. And here at Gamescom, we are revealing the gameplay of Civilization 7 for the first time.
I was about to say Civilization 6.
Tell us more, please welcome Ed Beach from Firaxis Games.
Drink every time a game dev gets cut off mid-speech. I'm going to hope that doesn't happen at the Game Awards later this year. Because he got a lot of shit for it last year. And I hope that's enough to be like, let's not.
Thank you, Shox. Thank you, Gamescom. It's hard to believe that it's been almost 8 years since Firaxis released our last Civilization game. So we're incredibly
eight
honored
years
to be
since
here
Civilization
tonight at Gamescom talking about
fucking hell.
Civilization 7. Civ 7. Civ 7 is by far the biggest, most ambitious game Firaxis has ever made. Everything from its new gameplay features to its gorgeous new art style is designed to immerse you in your own journey through history. Please join us after opening night live on the Firaxis Game Twitch channel for our official gameplay showcase, where we'll deep dive into what's new in Civ 7 and finally reveal our new in-game narrator. On behalf of the team at Firaxis Games, who has worked so hard on this game, I'm so excited to finally give the world its first look at Sid Meier's Civilization 7. Please, enjoy.
Last time it was Sean Bean. Huh? Civilization was the game. Fuck, I wish I played Civ 6 then.
Time when we were just discovering what games could be. And we said, let's put the entire history of the world into a game.
Yeah, how do these games work? I don't fully understand it. Because there's all different historic periods, right? Civilization Revolution was the shit on Xbox 360. That's the one I remember, Civilization Revolution. Never played it, but I remembered a lot of people were playing it and were talking about it. It was just kind of everywhere, like on store pages and shit, back in the olden days. Okay, February 11th, 2025. 9:30 p.m. UK time. All right.
Ever since we first reached for the stars.
Shattered Space?
We've been asking ourselves.
No. Yes. Yes, it is. Okay,
what
cool. Let's see.
Is out there. And more importantly, can we drive on it?
Oh, it's not. It's the fucking cars update! Oh, come on! Really? I was thinking it was going to be Shattered Space, and I was like, shit, come on, let's see what they're cooking. Fuck's sake. This cannot be a trailer just for that car, please. Okay, that's cool. In fairness, this is one hell of a fucking, like, funky trailer for a car. Starfield has gotten a lot better since launch. I said this.
Velocity at unsafe levels.
Well, so you can just chill in the back. That is cool.
The Rev 8 has landed.
Tonight? Oh shit! I love shadow drops like that. Speaking of shadow, Sonic Movie 3 trailer. Oh, Shadow Space. Anything? No. Oh, date! Don't think we had a date, did we? 30th of September? Ooh, okay.
There's two bits of Starfield news for you and a confirmation of the expansion Shattered Space that is coming out on
Shut
September
up, Gluten. Fuck
now
you
it's
on
time
about.
For an exclusive update on Marvel Rivals, the upcoming hero shooter from NetEase Games and
Insert
Marvel
Insert everyone moaning about hero shooters, although I hear this one's pretty good.
With a first look at their gameplay.
Not the Marvel Studios ass logo, what the hell?
Among the stars, Wakanda found a new home. And a new hope. The source of vibranium. The foundation of an empire.
Winter Soldier? Captain America, yep. I don't even know which characters were confirmed and weren't.
Snap out of it, Bucky.
Okay, I'm guessing Captain America hadn't been confirmed.
No.
Nor had Winter Soldier.
Not so fast.
Your battle's over.
Venom! Have to admit, I'm at least a little bit interested in trying this out for obvious reasons. But I have genuinely heard good stuff about this.
Victory.
This looks surprisingly fast-paced.
I can do this all day.
Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm surprised at the speed of the combat there. Oh, Doctor Doom! Launch date, December 6, 2024. Okay. All heroes locked in free to play at launch and beyond. What? Yo, okay.
Well, I'm sure everyone who played the beta wanted to know Marvel Rivals will launch on December 6, 2024. Now, Gamescom always strives to help the environment, and the event runs on 100% renewable energy and is climate friendly thanks to ongoing measures to reduce CO2 emissions.
Sorry.
Exhibitors participate in the Gamescom Goes Green Initiative.
There's going to be a catch. Well, the catch is going to be there'll be like skinging by in. I guarantee you what will wind up happening. Here's a prediction, which I think anyone can see coming. There'll be obviously Microsoft actions, but I bet you there'll be MCU skins for the characters.
And all of you can still help, of course. You can plant your.
It'll be just like Marvel's Avengers. I'm guaranteeing it.
And with that, it is time to reveal the winner of the Gamescom Sustainability Award. This award celebrates an organization in the global game industry committed to sustainability and the environment.
The catch is you cannot shit talk the game.
Please welcome back Lisa Buck with Playing for the Planet.
I think that audio cue started a bit too soon. I like that they're talking about stuff like this.
And hello, Gamescom. Thank you for having me again.
Problem is, my impatient ADHD ass is just like, show us trailers.
And in case some people don't know and need a quick refresher.
Oh, it's already had MCU skins leaked. What a fucking shocker.
Of gaming organizations.
Which ones?
Committed to taking climate action under the official umbrella of the United Nations. So how are things, Lisa?
Things are going great. Thank you. With 3.3 billion people around the world playing video games, we encourage everyone to make a difference wherever possible.
Absolutely, and 3.3
Oh yeah, and the beta, the NDA said you couldn't criticize the game. That was weird. That was weird. But what was weird about it was that it wasn't a bad game. Everyone was positive anyway. So it was a weird clause to have when people weren't going to criticize it anyway.
To avoid unnecessary energy consumption or switching to renewable energy electricity services at home to reduce your carbon footprint. Everything will make a difference.
Absolutely, every bit helps. Those are great tips, and I already utilize some of those myself, and I hope a lot more people will. But now, let's celebrate some of the amazing work already done by gaming companies.
Yes.
What have we got? Multiverse of Madness, Wonder, Zombie
Anyone
Strange, MCU No More, Endgame, Iron Man, Iron Spider,
targets,
and Volume 3, Six of the Guardians.
Delivering on
what?
That goal and turning it into emission reductions demands a clear and actionable plan.
Is that like
as
all
well
studios know their games are a shit or not? Wow.
And this year's winner has proven that it's possible to deliver ambition
to anyway.
With execution across the board. And this year's winner of the game.
Oh, those MCU skins you put in the chat there. What the
games.
Fuck?
And here to
Hang
accept
on, to
the award
these.
Is Brent Irvine, the vice chairman
we'll
of
at those
Tencent
later.
Games.
I was trying out with them on a different tab, but apparently that's not going to happen. Hang on.
First of all, let me say on behalf of Tencent Games how honored we are to receive this award. You know, Tencent
Games
encompasses
a
lot of things.
Let's have a quick
know, everything from in-house studios like Timmy,
peek.
Global studios
okay,
like Sharkmod,
so they're good.
To our global
publishers. Oh, those are sick. What
the
hell?
A commitment to operate
Yo!
In a sustainable way.
The Volume 3 Guardian suits. Yep, cool.
And
MCU
really
No More,
thank
okay.
All of our studios, all of our partners,
wow.
But most of all of our players.
That Iron Spider goes fucking hard, but the Wonder one, that is elite.
Wow. Efforts
okay.
To,
cool.
Our efforts to have positive change within the industry. Thanks again, and back to the games.
Congratulations, Tencent and Brent Irvine.
Sorry, I saw Deadpool and Wolverine for a second there. I was just checking something on my computer.
But that is not our only award. Everyone here and at home can vote for their favorite games playable at Gamescom in this year's Gamescom Awards.
But when
you
can
visit Gamescom now to help decide the winners.
Well, so every time I bring it up, you guys have to start doing
Thursday,
like a prayer lyrics.
August 22nd at 2 p.m. And the awards will then be celebrated this Friday at 2 p.m. at Gamescom Studio. Back to you, Jeff.
Thank you, Shox. You're doing a great job tonight. All right.
Yeah, she is. She's doing more than any
really
co-host
special
has.
For you. Please welcome Deadpool director, creator of Love, Death, and Robots, and the co-founder of Blur Studio, Tim Miller.
Oh, did you just say Deadpool to catch my fucking attention? You had me for a second then. All right, come on.
Thank you, Jeff. Blur Studio has been making cinematics for over 30 years now. That means classics like Quake, Star Wars, Warhammer, Call of Duty, and dozens more. And we do this because we fucking love video games.
This is gonna cry.
And every time a trailer comes online, we see hundreds and hundreds of comments from the fans, like, why don't we see a movie like this? Or why can't we have a series like this? And we could not agree more, which is why we are so excited to share this series with you. 15 original episodes created in collaboration with Amazon Studios and the publishers and developers of some of the world's greatest games.
Oh!
I'm talking new titles, existing games, indies, and classics. So we've been working on this show for 3 years. I get a little upset, choked up.
Yes, bless him, aw.
I cry a lot, sorry. All right, we've been working on it for 3 years, and I'm very emotional because I'm so excited. And it's finally time, so please enjoy the world premiere teaser of Secret Level.
You got this, man. You got this. You got this. Come on.
It is our love letter to games. And you can watch the series on Amazon Prime Video on December 10th. Not too far now. So enjoy. Thank you.
Good, man. All right, come on. So what, 15 episodes in the role for different games, I guess? So there's a Warhammer one.
It's time. This world has waited for your arrival. It is you. You will open the door. Because you are the chosen. All those moments. It's a new adventure.
Oh, I still got a war for a second then.
Just for you.
This looks sick, and most of the games aren't even games I've played. Dungeons and Dragons! I fucking thought I saw that!
Come in. You have a game to play.
That looks dope as fuck.
Young hero.
And now we move on.
Have taken an interest in your odyssey. Try not to disappoint us.
Odyssey? Honda Odyssey? I heard it fucks hard. So it's a TV series of 15 different standalone mini episodes based on different games that are meant to look like game trailers. People say that the trailers look sick and there should be a series. That's a really cool concept. That's really fucking cool. I hope that does well. I can't say I'll watch the ones for games I don't know, which means most of them, but like, that sounds fantastic. The name of this game, I remember seeing a trailer for it already. Agent Mythology Retold, that's it. Okay. Up to 7 days advanced access with the premium edition.
Play it day one with Game Pass.
Or play it on Game Pass. You know what I choose? Towerborn.
The tower is the only sanctuary we have left. Together, we can give our people the hope we need.
to survive.
Why did it say the name of the game in the bottom left corner when it started then? I think this is going to be like a multi-game sizzle reel, but that's odd. Delta Force. What is this? Whoa! Actual evolution? Delta Force Hawk Tour.
The conflict between the Alsara Guard and Havoc threatens the balance of the world. The Alsara Guard is a tempest of disorder, sowing chaos wherever it roams. But we are honed to strike at their very core.
Sniper Elite moment.
Havoc has cutting-edge technology, but is built on exploitation and suffering. United, we will plunge into the chaos.
I'm cautiously intrigued by this. What is this?
We are GTI. No one gets left behind.
Delta Force Hawk Ops. Oh, just Delta Force. What is that?
We are announcing is coming to Steam Next Fest in October in advance of its early access release later this year.
Okay.
All right, let's head back to the Middle Ages for a new look at Kingdom Come Deliverance 2.
Oh, here we go.
Authentic rendition of 15th century Bohemia as an action role-playing game.
All right, Ellie's going to carry the chat now for a bit.
I have concluded a very fragile truce with Sigismund, and if anyone should disrupt my plans with headstrong acts of violence, there will be consequences.
I intend to wage war, not parley.
Everything all right, eh?
We need more people. The best thing would be to recruit from your old comrades.
Well, if they're not already swinging on the gallows somewhere.
Will you help us, Henry?
Looks quite good visually. I still don't fully understand what the game is. Like, is it an open world game? What is it? Henry is the most British Isles name. Yeah, basically. Is it all first person as well? That's a bit strange. And actually, if it is all first person, that might put me off, I can't lie.
I like that boy already.
Well, there you go, gameplay premiere tomorrow. There you go, Ellie.
There is much more from that game coming this week during Gamescom. Now, last month, the ARPG Zenless Zone Zero was released from HoYoverse, and now we've got the debut of a brand new area of New Eridu. Check it out.
It's conveniently, my phone isn't that far away. How's everyone doing? We all okay? We all doing well? Don't mind me. I'm just zoning out for a little bit. Hoyo versus that Gustavo Fring. Imagine that. Yeah, they have like a fucking... they have like a cinematic universe for Los Poyos Hermanos. It's called the Poyoverse. You know, that would be hilarious. I'm going to be real with you, chat. I don't... We've got 40 minutes left. I don't know if we're going to get the Sonic 3 trailer. Which, on a real level, if we don't, like, this is the most bizarre marketing campaign, or should I say, lack of marketing campaign I've ever seen for a film. Because, like, we found out Jim Carrey was coming back and that Keanu Reeves was playing Shadow, what, 6 months ago? Jim Carrey coming back 6 months ago. Keanu Reeves playing Shadow maybe not quite as long ago, but a while ago. And like I said, if you go to like Walmart now in America, loads of Sonic 3 merch is available, like action figures, all sorts of shit with the Sonic Movie 3 branding on. Like, we know what Shadow looks like in the film because of the merch, whereas with Sonic 2, you didn't know what Knuckles looked like properly until the trailer came out, and that was half the excitement. So it's just like, shit. I still want the fucking trailer, but like, where is it? Where is it? The film comes out 4 months today. The 20th of December 2024 is the release date of Sonic 3. And yet...
I know her well. You do? I know all her deeds on the battlefield
quite well,
by heart.
Thank you, Reapers.
Such as... When General Fei Xiao fought her way in and out of enemy ranks 7 times with a single strike.
He got water under Mars' surface before the Sonic 3 trailer. Doctor Who moment. I'm just fiddling with a coaster. Quite cool. So I made a Funko Last of Us coaster. A belly. That's quite cool, doesn't it? Since I haven't got a drink on it, I've got another one over there with Joel on. Look. Look at that. Joel as well. General Fei Xiao shouted among the ruins. Got them at the Comic Con. I can't remember what Comic Con I got them at. Might have been Liverpool. I have even more impressive stories. Can you tell I really just do not care for what this is? I'm sorry if you do, but I'm not arsed.
Little girl, do you know how to get to the seat of divine foresight?
Oh, fucking Honkai Star Rail. What does that mean? I don't know what any of that means.
There's a fun little tease, and that was a new look at the space fantasy of Honkai Star Rail and Fei Xiao, a female general known for her prowess in martial arts. Okay, now we're heading to the Arkhamverse for Batman Arkham Shadow. It arrives later this year. It is a completely new Arkham story exclusive to MetaQuest 3. I played a demo of this, and I have to say the team,
Camouflage,
has done an incredible job bringing the world and combat into VR. And here is your first look at the actual gameplay, a gameplay trailer for Batman Arkham Shadow.
We should be counting how many shots was that. That's 3 times he said that so far, right?
This rat cult spreads through Gotham like a plague. I have to stop it. Even if it consumes me.
Have we had this discussion yet? Who is the fucking voice of Batman here?
The system has failed you.
That is very Kevin Conroy.
Angry. Bite back.
Roger Craig Smith. That man is my ghost. Holy fucking shit. He does a good... Well... I was going to say there's a good Batman, but it's just very Kevin Conroy.
Could be anywhere. A face in the crowd, a foot soldier in his own fanatical mob. So how in the hell do we find him?
Target, I was going to say, isn't that Troy Baker's voice?
Civil servants, public officials.
You could have been more than a symbol. You could have been a god.
Look out! It'd be weird if Troy Baker was playing another character in the Arkhamverse, because he played the Joker in Origins,
Alfred,
but...
We tried it your way, now we do it mine.
Something big's going down tonight. We repress our rage.
See, VR people are thinking this looks good. Our fears. I don't really have a frame of a reference to VR games, so...
Deep inside us.
You're everything that's wrong with Gotham! I'm done holding back.
So is this set after Arkham City, or does this work?
I can bring the Rat King to you.
Okay. Only on the MetaQuest 3. Wow, so cool. I will definitely buy one of those.
Well, that trailer was buzzing, and the whole city is buzzing during this week of games. And this weekend, the heart of our beloved gaming metropolis, Cologne, will transform into the vibrant Gamescom City Festival. There will be great music on 3 stages in the city.
Fucking epilepsy warning, maybe. Cheers.
With another 100,000 guests. Now, if you haven't been there yet, you should definitely go and check it out. That is what's happening in Cologne, and also people from more than 100 countries are here. But Gamescom has fans all over the world, and I have good news. Gamescom is heading to other continents.
Oh!
The first Gamescom LATAM took place in June and exceeded all of our expectations with over...
Oh wait, hang on, other continents. No, so it won't go anywhere closer to me. Germany's closest we'll get.
It was a fantastic show, and next year it's going to be even bigger.
It's still cool to do another conference, though. That's really cool.
Gamescom Asia returns this October. You can join in on the fun in the entertainment area to find out all about the games, the stage shows, cosplay, and much, much more. The ticket shop is already open, or you can also tune in to our online show Primetime on October 17th.
I'm guessing a North American one, Tim.
Now, who is ready for another world premiere?
About time. Come on.
Announced last year at ONL, here is a new look at Little Nightmares 3.
Oh, okay. So we do get Little Nightmares 3 in the end after all. That's not... When you say world premiere, I figured that means a game we haven't already seen announced. But, all right. I'm just going to shut up and let you all enjoy this. It's not my kind of thing, but... Sorry, I was just looking at there's been some stat changes to the Fortnite season currently. I was waiting to see things that got nerfed. Captain America's shield does slightly less damage, will require more accuracy to hone an enemy and staggers more quickly when blocking damage. That's fair. The shield was a bit overpowered. That's understandable. But it seems like they've not done much to War Machine's arsenal, which is good. Anyway. Are you all happy with that? No release date? Well, what a shame. Feels like most games these days, you get excited for them and you're like waiting for a release date. Actually, not most. That's cynical. That always sucks in the thing you're looking forward to, she doesn't have a fucking date. What is this? Why did Captain America swap actors? What are you on about? Hurdling. Okay. Cool, I guess. Did you not watch Endgame, KMD? It should be fairly obvious why there's a different Captain America now. What do you mean?
And I'm so glad we could share that with you tonight. All right, Gamescom, we have a special guest joining us next. I grew up playing his games, and many of you did too. Titles like Populous, Dungeon Keeper, Magic Carpet, Theme Park, Black and White, and Fable. And tonight he's here to reveal his brand new game, which he's secretly been working on for the past 3 years. Please join me, Gamescom, in welcoming to ONL, Peter Molyneux.
Okay. He listed a bunch of games that I didn't fucking know. Obviously, I know Fable, but, like, that was about it.
What an incredible honor it is to be here on the stage with Jeff.
Yes, Peter.
He's amazing.
This is so fun. So a couple months ago, you and I had lunch in London. I was like, what are you working on? You're like, well, I've actually been working on a game for a number of years. You've kept very quiet about it.
Yep.
You really wanted to, like, the game speak for itself.
Close enough.
But tell us about Masters of Albion.
Right. So after messing around on mobile, what the hell was I doing? I thought to myself, I need to come home. I need to come home to PC and console. So I've looked at Dungeon Keeper, I've taken some things that I've wanted to explore further with Dungeon Keeper. I've done the same with Black and White, I've taken the things from Black and White. I've done the same with Fable, and this is what I'm showing tonight.
And to your credit, you've self-funded this project yourself. Yeah. You put together a team of a lot of veterans from those games.
Yeah, I mean, I think my first realization is I needed to bring the old team back together again. So I'm working with people like Mark Healy and Russell Shaw and Ian Wright, the people that helped on and created Black and White, Dungeon Keeper, and Fable. Anyway, let's have a look at Masters of Albion.
All right, here's the world premiere, Masters of Albion, from Peter Molyneux.
He's looking so cool, dude. All right.
This is Masters of Albion.
What is Masters of Albion?
We're a team of 20 people dedicated to making something new, unique, and different.
Have you ever heard Albion was in Destroy All Humans 2? Yes, real.
Here we are in the familiar, vast world of Albion, packed with stories, quests, treasures, and monsters.
Fantasy and medieval games look all the same. What do you want about? What kind of take is that?
This is Oak Ridge. By day, you're tasked with building the town up, gaining resources, and earning money. By night, your town will be attacked by many of Albion's creatures. You can design anything. The food that people eat, the clothes they wear, the weapons they use, the armor they fight with. There is a strategy behind every creation. I can even feed them rats. My town's working hard to make that food. I can help out, or not. I can also design, customize, and create all buildings.
Whoa! Oh, this actually looks quite cool.
Night is coming, the sun is going down, and now my town needs defending against the horrors of Albion. And this is my hero's time to shine. You don't have to play in God mode. At any point, you can possess a character and play in third person.
Oh, I'm intrigued.
My hero is now under my complete control. And now it's time to fight.
Sound effects are a bit thingy. Like, I don't want to say tacky, but this looks really fucking cool.
My hero's getting overwhelmed. Let's switch back to God mode and unleash some real power.
So just, how is this just totally like a battle simulator? What are you on about, Kairi? No, it isn't.
Okay, we survived the night. Now, let's design a better weapon for my hero. You can be as silly.
Fuck off! Fuck off! Can you make bread into a sword? This looks like a hell of a lot of fun. What the hell?
An open world god game full of combat, choices,
the fridge be like!
It's available to wishlist on Steam now.
And consoles? You said you were returning to PC and consoles? Tell me it's coming to Xbox.
Management offer.
No!
We're all here.
He said PC and consoles earlier, so hopefully it is. That actually looks really fucking cool. Also, Squid Game game?
Player has been eliminated.
Uncle Ben, what happened? Squid Games! Can't wait for Squid Game Season 2 in December. Speaking of, fucking why have Disney cancelled The Acolyte? Bullshit, man. At least I get to see Lee Jung-jae do something else fucking brilliant. That man's a fantastic actor.
It's how you play the game.
Octopus activities, fuck's sake. This looks goofy enough to be quite fun, I can't lie. Terminator reference? Oh. Is it only on mobile? Fuck.
I've been here before. In the fall.
I'm not being funny. Like, I don't understand how anyone can ever be glad that a show gets cancelled.
Who I might become.
I think I probably said that about the iron, but that was genuinely shit. But I don't know. Just. Yeah. This looks fun, 400 OS, fuck yeah, basically.
It is time to awaken. My duty, my journey, to step into the unknown.
Yeah, the Acolyte was good. I thought it was. Most people who shat on it hadn't even fucking watched an episode, so I don't want to hear any of it. Was it a perfect show or an amazing show? No, not at all. But so many shows have weaker first seasons. I mean, Star Wars The Clone Wars, if that had come out today, it wouldn't have got past the first season. And it's very telling. I'm a bit concerned, chat, I can't lie. We have less than half an hour left, and I've not really been hooked by particularly anything here. Masters of Albion did look good, but I didn't see an Xbox tag there, so I'm a bit like, did I have more negative reviews than I have viewed? Yeah, because people fucking review bombed it. They review bombed it so much that another show called Acolytes, or film, that wasn't even tied to it, got completely review bombed because people were so blind to hate that they couldn't even do it on the right fucking thing. Shit like that's ridiculous. Now, apparently, it didn't get many views. And that is a reason to cancel it, fine. But the atmosphere around it saying it was hated, no. It, like, there were people with fucking stupid going, oh yeah, I'm scared of a show, or I don't like it because there's a black character in it, or a gay character, or whatever. Was there even a gay character in it? Like, weird. I don't understand it. Like, there are people who look slightly differently to you and suddenly it's a problem. People like that, I really wish people like that just didn't have platforms, but whatever. If Clone Wars came out today, people would have said we don't care about clones or Ahsoka. Yeah, exactly. Well, to be fair, people didn't like Ahsoka when the Clone Wars movie came out in 2008. But
Arena Breakout Infinite is now available.
The interesting narrative about that is people are now shitting on every other Star Wars show, saying we're stuck with these. But Ahsoka was fantastic.
Blizzard has been a big part of Gamescom history, and this week we are thrilled to welcome them back for the first time since 2019.
Overwatch 2.
Tell us more. Here is the president of Blizzard, Johanna Ferris.
I mean, the new season just came out, so. What a totally normal thing to say, KMD. What a totally normal thing to say that you definitely should reconsider saying.
Hello,
in the
hello,
future.
Hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Welcome to Gamescom.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having us on behalf of Blizzard. This is such a massive moment, but it's such a special time to be sharing it here with everyone at Gamescom, and we're just really honored and grateful to be here.
Well, we're very glad to have you guys back. And I know you got a big booth with Xbox, right?
We do, yes. And come on by if you're here all week long. We're proud of it. But it's also a particularly big moment for Warcraft. We have celebrations and anniversaries galore across Hearthstone, across
Why
Rumble,
did I think this was Michelle Obama? I don't know. Why did you think she was Michelle Obama?
This year.
Yes, speaking of World of Warcraft, The War Within, it's
I don't like how they retconned Anakin's origin slightly in Kiani Mundi. Let's just debunk that. Anakin origin wasn't debunked, retconned at all. There was something to do with someone created via the Force that doesn't impact how Anakin was created. And the Kiani Mundi thing was never official anyway. His age was often, like, it was just a legends thing that was never fully confirmed. And the whole, the Sith have been extinct for millennia. Every Jedi who knows about Kamir other than Venestra is dead. She's probably wrapped it up, or maybe told Yoda. And even if Kiani Mundi knew, the whole point of the prequels was that the Jedi were blind and were fucking stupid and up themselves and didn't accept threats because they thought they were too powerful to have not spotted one.
Very exciting that this month is
the idea that the Acolyte fucked up the prequels when it was written by someone who loved the prequels and wants to add more to the prequels is just insane.
Yeah, there's a ton of ways
we could have fucking seen Darth Plagueis.
So we definitely hope that you join us.
How is that? Oh man, how is that a bad thing? I don't understand it. I don't get it. Oh god, I need to shut up before I get really annoyed. I can't believe it. I'm so pissed. Yeah, I got cancelled. I'm only talking over this because I don't care about World of Warcraft. Sorry.
And also be on the lookout for our very first Warcraft Direct, where the team will share more in the coming months on all the things going on for the Warcraft universe.
Okay, well, that's exciting.
None of that's against you, by the way, Devil. I know you made those points, but they're just points I see a lot since the app came out, and I'm just like,
no.
They are. There'll be some nice surprises along the way. Star Jar Jar canon.
It technically isn't that Lego film they're doing.
The Overwatch 2 team.
This is me coping, but I hope they don't fumble next to the Old Republic remake. I'm just glad it's still happening. I'm just glad it's still happening, to be honest. I thought it was in the bin. I thought it was in the bin a while ago, but...
There'll be a new...
Because I did go to play it, and I just didn't... I didn't love it. I didn't... I like, it's a little bit too old.
New skin. It's Widowmaker.
Oh, what?
And she's embracing her allegiance for the Horde as Sylvanas Windrunner.
That's kind of cool if you're a World of Warcraft fan.
From the Overwatch team on that.
Okay, thanks for bringing a little
Star Wars fans be like, they made the Jedi bad as the prequels didn't literally do that. Yeah, like, there were quite a few hints of people not trusting the Jedi, which I love because that is tying into the prequels.
All eyes on October 8th. Yes. We are super excited for the Vessel of Hatred, and we're even more excited that here
as Justin Darth Plagueis, so was I, Devil. I fucking shat myself when I saw him.
First ever,
and I also just really like Khmer as a character. The twist that he was the stranger, I saw that coming a mile away. It wasn't very well set up, I'll be honest.
Awesome to play,
but as a character, he was really fascinating. And I love that the story ends. I may as well spoil it now because it's fucking cancelled. With a good guy turning bad. Like, I know that's obviously a bit Anakin-y, but like, we end with all the good guys, or most of them being dead, and two Sith working together, and we know that they're going to be doomed because there's only two Sith and Plagueis is around. Like, what they would have done with that, I would have been really intrigued by, but now we'll never see.
Suffering. Desolation.
Anyway, yeah. Sorry, this is just your resident Star Wars nerd with more lightsabers than he should have, saying that a show shouldn't have got cancelled.
However, some of us have taken a different path. Bound by secrecy, ready to stand and fight.
This is me stopping to cope in hopes I jinx it. I've lost hope for Sonic 3 trailer. Ellie, and I'll be honest, I lost hope a while ago.
Time we fought the
Didn't you sell your lightsaber?
Sanctuary.
No? And what do you mean lightsaber? You can't see off camera. You can't see off camera, man. Oh dear.
Our inner demons. But the return of hatred has pulled us back into the light.
Show them lightsabers, we'd be here all night. We would be here all night.
And though we now wait, watching from the shadows,
maybe one day I'll do like a full lightsaber showcase video or something. I would like to do like some TikToks or Insta reels or something of like all each of the different lightsabers. Why are you saying didn't you sell your lightsabers? I've never said this. Why have two people different people said that? Why? I've never said that. They should recanonize the Old Republic and make the link between the army and the Sith and Rule of Two. That would be fantastic. That would be fantastic, but they're not going to do it now because, like, realistically, this just proves that Disney's not going to back any Star Wars things outside the main 9 film timeline. And that is just heartbreaking.
Strength in numbers.
Yeah, I sold a bunch of pops, but not saves. I've still got loads of pops, but I just sold a bunch of old ones that I needed them off.
I am your rage.
We are the Pale Hand, and we are the reason you need never fight alone.
Okay.
That looks great. Thanks for the sneak peek.
Course, and it's my esteemed pleasure to introduce Brent Gibson.
I doubt it's going to show up during the show, so the game's generations trailer ready. You just keep that link copied, Ellie, and send it
to me
at the end. Or actually, DM me it on Discord, that'll be easier.
The team and I are so proud that Diablo 4 is the type of game.
I still talking about Diablo 4? Fucking hell.
And in Vessel of Hatred, it's no exception. We are hard at work at adding new ways to play and new ways to grow in power, like mercenaries. Ordinary people with extraordinary skills that you can hire to fight alongside you in your battle against hell. We're also adding the Kurost Undercity, an all-new multi-layered dungeon that gives you the control.
There you go. Thank you very much, Elian, for DMing it to me.
As well as the rewards you may get.
Did I spot your Discord on Star Wars Outlaws? Elian was busy gaming. Yeah, I've still got it open right now, and I have to be very careful I don't switch to it while I'm streaming because I can't show anything from it. It's embargoed.
About combat in Diablo through a gauntlet.
Yeah, I should actually mention that since they're talking about Diablo and I don't give a shit about Diablo. I was very lucky enough to be sent a code for Star Wars Outlaws by Ubisoft today. It doesn't even come out on early access till the 27th, and the general release is August 30th. And the embargo is not till August 26th, so I've got 6 days to play the game.
So thank you very
much. I'm fucking thrilled by that. I'm very grateful to Ubisoft for that. Very grateful.
Thanks, Brent.
So I'm excited to see what I think of it. I will make a video on it, I think. I definitely think I'll make a video on it.
Berserker Kazan, set for 2025.
Isn't Ubisoft trying to charge 100 plus for a single level? No, they're not. They're doing a gold edition or an ultimate edition that has a bonus Jabba the Hutt level, which is annoying. I don't like the practice of that at all.
Let's witness the chaos that awaits.
Right, what is this now?
The two wolves who defeated the beast.
Sick. Yeah, I'm dead happy about it, Grouse, honestly. I'm really happy about it. It's dope. Nice to see you here, by the way, buddy.
Of the aged lion.
For years, I faced unrelenting fury. Made countless sacrifices. And the result of my devotion was betrayal.
Kind of hyped for that game. Probably just going to do Ubisoft subscription and beat it in a month. Yeah, it's probably a pretty good strategy. Yeah, I was looking at a lot of discourse about this, and especially since Nadeshot made a clip that kind of went semi-viral that was saying about how people want games to fail these days, which it does feel like that sometimes. Like, Star Wars Outlaws, for everything I've seen, and this is speaking as someone who has literally played 20 minutes and I'm not going to talk about the game, purely reception for trailers, because obviously I can't break embargo. I thought it looked really good from the trailers, and people were talking about it like it was good from the trailers, but because it was a Ubisoft game, everyone's like, oh, it's going to be shit, it's going to be shit. I'm just like, can we not try and at least have a bit of hope for these things? Like, maybe it's great, maybe it's shit, we don't know. I don't know. I've literally barely touched it, and even if I had done much, I wouldn't say it again. Obviously, not breaking NDA. But, like, it really does feel like people are rooting for games to fail these days, and it sucks. Because everything I'd seen about Outlaws looked fucking cool, and that's why I was so keen to get a review code for it, and why I'm so glad that I have got one. But I genuinely, in the back of my head, I'm like thinking, if I put a video out on that, I'm so ready for people to comment Ubisoft chill. I barely stopped getting the fucking shill comments on Payday 3 videos, so fuck knows what'll happen when I do a Star Wars Outlaws video. People are super jaded for no reason, or there are reasons, but still, like, chill. Yeah, exactly. It's ridiculous. I'm gonna be honest, chat, I'm completely zoning out of this now. This, like, I know games are for different people with different tastes, but for me personally, this has been one of the most, like, kind of average / uninteresting game events ever. I really do not care for, like, 99% of what's been here.
And every turn becomes an opportunity to triumph.
I know your voice.
It's your world now.
Is that Deborah Wilson? Okay.
Play it day one with PC Game Pass.
Manifesting Dead of Wolves gameplay, so either ignore it, plays a GT4, I'll be interested in it. Well, hype seems to be going for Dead of Wolves. People seem to be intrigued with it, so that's good. I'll have to have a peek and see what I think of it. You see with adverts that are medieval people fighting skeletons. Dark and darker mobile. Okay. Can we finish the Sonic Movie 3 trailer? Can we make it happen?
Dark and Darker Mobile is now available
Please.
For global pre-registration. Now from NetEase Games, this next trailer is a new life simulation game where players can travel among super-powered worlds to craft their island and engage with friends. Let's take a look.
Genuinely, the most exciting thing that's happened this stream for me is Jennifer English being announced for Liverpool Comic Con. and I've met her already. That was more exciting to me than the rest of this fucking event, man. Please, come on. I know Borderlands 4 is a big thing, but I don't play Borderlands, so that doesn't do anything for me. Yeah, this looks a bit Animal Crossing-y-esque. I still would like to play Animal Crossing as actual game itself, but I don't own a Switch, so I can't. Maybe I'll get a Switch 2 when it comes out. We'll see. Human Crossing. Imagine if that's what they called it. This whole event makes me relate to Tim earlier. Makes me want to cry. Yeah. Don't worry, we'll watch the Sonic X Shadow Generations trailer after this, and then at least there'll be something I care about. This is quite cute. Floatopia. Okay.
All right,
nine
we
minutes
got
left.
Another game to show you, which will take you on an epic global adventure. Indiana Jones and the Great Circle.
Oh, I forgot
Circle.
This was
going to
be show
Check
up here.
Out.
Come on, Troy Baker, what have you got for us?
What if I told you there was a connection between ancient cultures around the world? A Great Circle. Does it exist? Is it the key to some lost power? That's up to you to uncover.
Hello, Mario. Hello,
I'm Troy Baker, and I play Indy. It's humbling playing a character that so many people, myself
included, look up to. Is that the Jonesy voice? Come on, man.
As a kid, seeing Indiana Jones in the theater for the first time
yes.
was a defining moment for me. And I never would have guessed that all these years later, I would be the one wearing the hat. But here I am. It's been a dream come true. A dream that I cannot wait for you to live for yourself. The beauty of a first-person game like this is that we all get to feel what it's like to become Indy. You are the one who cracks the whip, who feels the weight of every punch and the thrill of finding every clue. Indy is such a unique character. Professor, an archaeologist, a brawler, an explorer. The quintessential all-around.
He's talking
adventure.
Like he made the game. He is, isn't
this game
he? Yeah.
Has everything you'd expect from an Indiana Jones adventure. Mysterious artifacts, cunning villains, ancient discoveries, hard-hitting action.
De-aging
it's a world
CGI.
Of constant danger where you've got to think on your feet to stay alive. The Great Circle spans the entire globe, from snake-filled jungle temples to scorpion-riddled desert tombs. Stunning open areas to explore freely.
It does look interesting.
For you to discover.
And I mean, I'll always be a Troy Baker enjoyer, so I don't mind that he's playing Indy, although I wonder if he could sound a bit more like Harrison Ford.
Will immerse you in the mystery, providing extra info on all of your finds, so you can appreciate all of the little historical details he obsesses over. And those details
will it be the Lego game? Absolutely not.
The
How dare you even suggest that?
That hold the secrets you're after. But ancient secrets don't come easy. It's best to have an exit strategy. This is an incredible new way to experience Indiana Jones, and I can't wait for you to play it. Hold on to your hat.
Okay. When's it even coming out? We got a date? We probably have already had a date, but I don't remember it.
Doesn't that look great? A world of mystery to explore. But you're probably wondering when the game comes out, right? Well...
Did we not know it until now? Oh, so when is it? December 9th, okay. Cool.
There you have it. Indiana Jones and the Great Circle is coming out this December for Xbox, Game Pass, and PC. But there is one more thing that Machine Games and Bethesda wanted to share with you about Indiana Jones and the Great Circle.
And what's that? Oh.
The game's coming to PlayStation 5 in spring of 2025. All right, before we wrap up ONL, we do have one final game announcement for you. Check this out.
All right. Well, it's not the Sonic 3 movie trailer. I fucking saw that coming and should have known it wouldn't happen.
This thing of ours. It's a brotherhood. Treachery. And deceit.
Stop saying fear and greed. Fucking
not exist among us.
Read World War II, too?
Yourself. Your life. Do this, family.
Mafia of the old country. Okay. Mario said that the exact same time it came up on my screen, and I was like, is that a guess or is that confirmed? And then bam. Huh. Happy for- oh, was that? Were you guessing?
What you just saw first.
To be fair, I literally guessed Borderlands 4 from the 2K logo. So we both had a moment this stream.
We're going back to the roots of what fans love about the Mafia franchise, crafting a deep, linear narrative with that classic mob movie feeling. Mafia's success is built on our players' passion for the franchise, and we're so proud to return to Mafia with the old country. We can't wait to show you all.
So, Sonic Movie 3 trailer still not coming. So what was the non-gaming stuff he was talking... Oh, I guess the Secret Level series.
Right? All right, well, that is a wrap on Opening Night Live from here in Cologne, Germany. And we hope to see you again this December 12th, when the Game Awards streams live everywhere for our 10th anniversary show. And it's going to be a very special night as we give you a sense of where games are going in the next decade. We don't want to say much now, but... trust me, it's going to be a very special show. All right, well, thanks again to my co-host, Shox. Didn't she do a great job?
Thank you so much, Jeff. It was really great to be here. I hope everyone had an amazing time. And can I say something in German, too?
Let's do it.
Don't want to show you up, but... vielen Dank, ihr Lieben. Ich hoffe, ihr habt einen super...
Okay, cool. Nobody cares. Right, so, Sonic Shadow Generations trailer. Let's see what this looks like, because I want to watch this. I haven't watched it. So at least you get me... we can see something that I care about. I'll move on from there. Yeah, I'm going to be honest with you, chat. Again, it's all about perspectives. If there's loads of games there you care about, that's fantastic. Very happy for you. But personally, that's one of my least favorite gaming events we've watched on stream. There was basically nothing I cared about there. I always say if there's like even one big thing I care about, I'm happy. There wasn't even one big thing I care about. So that is a shame. Anyway, let's see what we've got with Sonic X Shadow Generations for the new trailer. Let's see what we have. I've not seen anything from this.
Something calls to me.
We meet again, Shadow the Hedgehog.
Fucking Black Doom. I still can't believe they brought Black Doom back.
All you want, you cannot deny your fate.
New Doom Spears. Oh yeah, these are all abilities from Doom, I guess. Blast, okay. So hang on, this is like Sonic Frontiers then, I guess, right? All the different moves you can do. Fucking music, shit! Oh my god, the music! Doom, wait, now this is the shit that looks so cool. Frontiers down to Chaos Island. I was gonna say, was that from Sonic Frontiers? I swear I'd seen someone mention that. Okay. Doom, sir. Why is the fucking... go away with the overlays. Oh, no way! No fucking way! No fucking way! No! No! I'm sorry, I realize nobody else cares, and this might be the most fucking immature reaction ever. You're fucking kidding me they got Neo Metal Sonic in this fucking game. You're kidding me! No fucking way! No! Oh my god! I want to cry. What the fuck? What the fuck? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh! I'm so sorry to all of your ears. I greatly apologize. That makes up for it. That makes up for the entirety of fucking Gamescom. Oh my god. I literally just fucking bought the figure. I don't collect Sonic action figures. Neo Metal Sonic is, I've said this before, my favorite fucking boss in anything in Sonic history. Like, out of anything. And to see the Metal Overlord version of him as a boss in the next... Oh my god. I can't express how happy that makes me. This game has been made for me. It's a fucking shadow game. You go back through Westopolis. There's Black Doom. There's Frontier-style combat. And references to Frontiers. A fucking open-world hub world. And Metal Sonic coming back as Metal Overlord, Neo Metal Sonic. My brain's actually just shut off. I can't believe that. This game is literally made for me. Like fucking Izuka was sat in his office like, all right, we need to make a game for Red Arch Alive. And you know what? I could fucking kiss you, man.
I am the true ultimate life form.
I can't believe it. I cannot believe that. And they have also just announced a collector's edition. I don't know if they're going to show it here. No, they're not going to show it here, but it's fucking $250. I'm not spending that, but... Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. That might be the most nerdy reaction you've ever seen from me, chat. I genuinely will make absolutely no apologies for it. I'll make none. Because, oh my god. Oh my god. Fucking hell. Amazing. Fucking amazing. I'm so happy about that. I'm so happy about that. Acts like that on Payday 3's gameplay trailer, so you're good. That's fair. Has anyone else got fucking... Yep, they just dropped Metal Overlord like it was nothing. Oh. Fucking hell. Oh, my god. I like Sonic, but Shadow's been my favorite because of his air skates. His edgy style is fun in a cheesy way. Yeah, I love Shadow the Hedgehog. I love it. I really love him. I love him to bits. I can't believe Metal Overlord. What the fuck? I'm genuinely, like, shaken a bit by that. Like, I'm shaken. I can't believe they've done that. My bigger thing is Chaos Arms in the trailer and Shadow wasn't in Frontiers. Yeah, so where was that? Because I saw that too. Chaos Island, which is one of the islands in Sonic Frontiers. Where was that? That looked a bit like one, but I'm not sure if that was it. Where was it? Yeah, there it is. Here it is. Frontiers, ah shit. What, like... I did say the only thing I'd have loved in Sonic Frontiers to make it better would have been Shadow the Hedgehog. It didn't need to be in the game, though. It's fair. But, like... If we're going to Sonic Frontiers area, Chaos Island, then what are the implications for Sonic Frontiers? Shadow being a part of all that, yeah. Shit. I can't even begin to express. Oh. I just. Oh my god. Oh my god. Well, whether this is one of those few situations. It's like Life is Strange Double Exposure. I've said this already. Where, like, whether I get a review key or not, I don't care. I really don't care. I will put whatever money necessary into this, whether I have the money or not. I don't care. I am so thrilled by the fact that this game exists. I just can't believe it. If I'm playing Generations and Find Your Flame hits Game of the Year, if we hear any Frontiers music in this fucking game, I'll lose my shit, dude. I will lose my shit. Imagine. Fuck. I still think Goat Sim had the most wild trailer. Definitely Codeine. Yeah. That trailer was brilliant, and then it was just for Goat Simulator Remastered, which I just don't really care about, which is a real shame. There you go. That's everything. That was a pretty shit event, I'll be honest. Nothing against Jeff Keighley or Gamescom or anything like that. It's whatever. But, man, I just... I said it already, but genuinely, if you've seen a lot of games there that you like, That's great. That's fantastic. I'm really happy for you. For me, nothing there grabbed me. I just find that to be a real shame. But there you go. There you go. I don't know what the next gaming event is. I suppose, is it the Game Awards? I guess it has to be, right? I don't think there's another game, like, game showcase thing happening now until then. As far as I know.
There's a machine that goes.
Spock, I'm in with the fire. Thank you very much. But yeah, so do let me know what you all think. I really appreciate it. We will be back. Ooh, when's the next stream going to be? Shall we do one tomorrow? Might do one tomorrow. I will let you know. I want to do more streams this week, I did say. I haven't fully planned it out. I really should have planned it out. That would have been a good idea. Probably do a stream tomorrow. Don't know what we'll do. We'll see. I do need to play the new Crime Boss updates. Maybe we'll do that. Maybe we'll go... I mean, I should go back to Sonic Heroes, especially now I've seen this. I kind of want to go back and carry on with Sonic Heroes. We started playing that about a month or two ago. Wouldn't mind going back to that. And we need to restart the Baldur's Gate 3 series too. So, whatever. I'll see. I'll see. Well, I'll think about it. I'll think about it. I'll think about it. I'll plan some stuff out. Maybe we'll do both of those this week. Maybe we'll do all three of those. Maybe I'll stream every night this week. Fuck it. I don't know. We'll see. I might be busy on Friday, I think. Am I busy on Friday? Let me just consult my schedule. What's happening on Friday? Friday afternoon I'm busy, so maybe Friday night. But no, at least tomorrow and Thursday I could stream. So yeah, we'll see. All right, people. I will see you all probably tomorrow for the stream. Thank you all for watching. If you've enjoyed, please make sure you drop a follow. You can check out my link tree via the links command there. Oh, and Noelle's beat me to it and the Discord server. You can see it there as well to join and see me yap. But I hope you all enjoyed the reaction, even if it was a little bit dead as an event. I hope, hopefully my reaction to the Shadow trailer at the end made up for it. I've just realized I'm on the wrong screen. Why has nobody pointed out that I'm on a fucking black screen? I'm meant to be on this screen. Sorry. There we go. But yeah, appreciate you all being here. Let's see if there's someone we can raid. Who's streaming right now? Who is streaming? Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. What the fuck is this weird overlay thing to knock to ask to collaborate? I need to get rid of this because I can't even fucking tell people's profile pictures anymore. Bizarre. Let's raid Liz. Liz is streaming Payday 3. Let's drop in on her. Out. Oh, that's her stream audio. Thought I had Twitch muted, but apparently I don't. Let's go raid her. All right, cheers for watching, everyone. Thank you all. Literally about 50 of you throughout the stream, which is kind of nuts. I don't think we've had that much for a video game conference thing before, just generally, which is really, really cool. So thank you all. Much love for that. Much appreciated. So enjoy Liz's stream. I'll see you all soon with some new content. I should make a Crime Boss video tomorrow, but I don't know how much time I've got, and I'm honestly going to want to put some time into Outlaws. So I feel like if I'm not making a Payday video now, I'm just going to be playing a lot of Star Wars Outlaws because I really want to make a video on that. So we will see. We will see. But thank you very much for hanging out. Greatly appreciate it. And I will see you all soon. Much love. Take care. And yeah, see you later. Bye.